You take away the sin and made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God besides you who hath the care of all, that you need show you not unjustly condemned. For your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved. And in those who know you, you rebuke to mimicry. But though you are the master of might, you judge with clemency. And with much lenience, you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind. And you gave your children good ground for hope that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsible song. Lord, you are good and forgiving.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
You, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in kindness to all who call upon you. Hearken, O Lord, to my prayer and attend to the sound of my pleading.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
All nations you have made shall come and worship you, O Lord, and glorify your name, for you are great, and you do wondrous deeds. You alone are God.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
You, O Lord, are a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger, abounding in kindness and fidelity. Turn toward me and have pity on me. Give your strength to your servant.
Lord, you are good and forgiving.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
While everyone was asleep,
his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, "Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?" He answered, "An enemy has done this." His slaves said to him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" He replied, "No. If you pull up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat along with them. Let them grow together until harvest. Then at harvest time, I will say to the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn." The Gospel of the Lord. It's hard to believe it's the fifth day of the novena in honor of St. Anne. Many of you have asked if this Mass will be for Sunday, and I said yes. So you know that this Mass is for Sunday already. The readings that we have just heard proclaimed are for this Sunday, and Jesus gives another parable. Remember, last Sunday was the parable of the sower and the seed. The sower and the seed. And this week, he gives the parable of the weeds among the wheat. That while everyone was asleep, an enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. That's the struggle, my friends, that we deal with good and evil. Good and bad in our lives. It's almost like a tug of war going on inside of us. There'll always be the weeds among us because we're sinners, every one of us, and so obviously the weeds would be considered sin. And when the enemy comes to us, he sows within us the seeds of sin in our lives. Thank God for grace, huh? Thank God for reconciliation. Thank God for confession. That we're able to come to Jesus, as we heard last night, to experience his mercy and his forgiveness. As we all know, his mercy endures forever. At the conclusion of one's confession, I say, "Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever." And when we acknowledge that mercy of God through the act of forgiveness, those weeds get separated from the wheat of our lives. And actually, really, the weed that the Lord is talking about in this particular parable, if you would read a scripture commentary, you would notice that it's like a poison. It's like a poisonous weed that he's talking about in reference to growing among the wheat. It's almost as tall as the grain of wheat. It becomes poisonous to the wheat. And that's what the reference to the weeds and wheat in the parable is all about. But notice what we hear in Wisdom, the first reading. There is no God besides you who have the care of all that you need show you have not just unjustly condemned. For he judges with clemency, the master of might, and with much lenience you govern us. That's the kind of God we have in dealing with the weeds of the sinfulness of life. We have a God who shows clemency, mercy, and with much lenience, you govern us for power whenever you will attends you. And then the second reading says, as St. Paul to the Romans, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And so there's always someone who comes to our aid. There is always someone who judges us with leniency and clemency, and that is God, Jesus. We all deal with the weeds of life. That's why we come to a novena like this, because we need help. We need assistance. We need intercession. Through the powerful intercession of a saint, that we place our faith in the providence of God, Saint Anne, through the power and throne of Jesus, that our requests, our needs, our prayers will be granted. Friends, we cannot do it on our own. We need the power of prayer. We need the power of God. We need the sacraments, reconciliation, forgiveness, and above all, we need the source and summit of our faith in life, the Holy Eucharist, which is Jesus himself, to nourish us, to feed us, and strengthen us for the journey of life and faith. And so, do not be afraid, as oftentimes we're told. There will always be the stuff of life, the weeds of life. Notice he said, let them there. Don't pull them up. Let them grow together. And then at the time of harvest, our harvest, of course, is going to be eternal life. At the time of harvest, then we'll get rid of the things, that's through the sacraments, we'll get rid of the things that become weeds, so that all that we will harvest is the good, and present it all to the throne of Jesus when we stand before God face to face. Let us hope and pray for the grace, and let us hope and pray that we all get there. Novena prayers in honor of Saint Anne. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, incline unto my aid, O God. Let us together pray. O Almighty God, Father of mercies and giver of all good gifts, we kneel before you to honor you and your saints, and to seek their intercession in our many needs. We are truly sorry for all our sins, and humbly ask your pardon. Please grant our petitions, and the full measure of the indulgences granted by your vicar, the Pope, and draw us ever nearer your divine heart. Amen. Prayer to Saint Anne, Mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary. With a heart full of sincere and filial veneration, I prostrate myself before you, O blessed Saint Anne. You are that beloved and privileged creature, who because of your extraordinary virtue and sanctity, did deserve of God that chief of graces, of giving life to the treasury of grace, the blessed among women, the mother of the incarnate Lord, the Blessed Virgin Mary. All in consideration of such exalted favors, please, O most tender saint, receive me among the number of your truly devoted servants, for such I profess myself to be and wish to remain for the rest of my life. Surround me with your efficacious patronage and obtain for me from God the imitation of those virtues with which you were so profusely adorned. Obtain for me a knowledge of my sins and sorrow for them, an ardent love of Jesus and Mary, and a faithful and constant observance of the duties of my stated life. Save me from all dangers in life, and assist me in the hour of my death, that I may safely reach paradise, there to praise with you, most happy mother, the Word of God made man, in the womb of your most pure daughter, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Prayer to Saint Anne to obtain a special favor. O glorious Saint Anne, filled with compassion for those who invoke you, and with love for those who suffer, heavily laden with the weight of my troubles, I cast myself at your feet and humbly beg of you to take the present affair, which I recommend to you under your special protection.
Please recommend him to your daughter, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and lay it before the throne of Jesus, so that he may bring it to a happy issue. Please continue to intercede for me until my request is granted. Above all, obtain for me the grace of one day beholding my God face to face, and with you and Mary and all the saints, praising and blessing him for all eternity. Good Saint Anne, Mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our requests. Good Saint Anne, Mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our requests. Good Saint Anne, Mother of her who is our life, our sweetness, and our hope, pray to her for us and obtain our requests. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Good Saint Anne,
pray for us.
And through the intercession of Good Saint Anne, we ask her intercession that all of the needs and petitions and prayers, especially to those mentioned in the prayer basket and the intentions and all those we bring in this novena, be answered and placed at the throne of Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us stand now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. For him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Confident in the providence of God, we now place our needs before the Father. For the church, that just as the mature mustard tree is a dwelling place for the birds of the sky, we may be a dwelling place for all people, we pray to the Lord. That leaders in government will promote the dignity of all persons, especially those whose voices are often not heard, we pray to the Lord. For all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special intention book near our cross, and intentions in this novena, we pray to the Lord. And for all who have died, especially for Joseph and Kathleen, McEwen, for whom this Mass is being offered, and others we would like to remember, we pray to the Lord. Loving God, hear and answer these petitions through Christ our Lord.
Please join in singing Amazing Grace, now that we celebrate hymnal number 700.
Celebration, we acclaim.
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
All the saints, St. Anne, who have pleased you throughout the ages.
day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil and violence. Graciously grant peace in the Ukraine and all the war-torn areas of our world. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, honor, and glory. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other peace.
Thank you.
tie into the feast, obviously, of Saint Anne. The grandparents of Jesus is Anne and Joachim, and their feast day will be on the 26th of July. So it's no mistake that Pope Francis declared this particular Sunday this week for grandparents and the elderly, because he considers himself almost like a grandfather in many ways. He's 86 years old. And so he always admires the wisdom of the elderly and the wisdom of grandparents to their grandchildren, because they lived a lot longer, obviously, and they are wise in so many things. Talk about dealing with the weeds and the wheat of life. Who better to give an example than our grandparents? I only knew one of my grandparents, but there are some who are blessed to know their both sides of their grandparents right up to their elderly years. And so this blessing is for you who are grandparents and the elderly, because your perseverance in life, your wisdom that you have, and all that you can give to young people today, and especially World Youth Day is going to be on this 1st to the 6th in Lisbon, Portugal. Andrew, our seminarian, is going to Lisbon. He just came back from Ghana, and he's going now to Portugal. Must be nice, isn't it? But anyway, World Youth Day. So what the Pope is saying to the young people is, learn from these people. Learn from their wisdom of life and all that they can give to you, because they have so much to give. So this blessing goes to you, grandparents and the elderly. May the Lord shower his blessing upon all of you grandparents and elderly, because of your wisdom and your perseverance through the difficulties and the struggles of life and the sacrifices that you have made over the years. You have so much to give to young people today. May they learn from you, and may they learn from your example. And may this blessing be upon you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us stand and pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Have a good evening, everybody.
Please join me in singing our hymn to Saint Anne, down on the prayer card.
Hi, Tony. Double duty tonight, huh?
The extra holy.